Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Welcome to NIVS Home School. I hope you all are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. This is Kamrun Nahar, assistant teacher of National Ideal English Version School, Day Shift. Today I am going to take a Bangladesh and Global Studies class for the students of class 8. And I am going to discuss lesson 6 and 7 from chapter 11. So all of you take your Bangladesh and Global Studies book. It will be helpful for you to understand the topic. And could you remember what is the name of this chapter? Yes, the name of this chapter is the minority ethnic groups of our what country? Groups of Bangladesh. And so I hope all of you have taken your book. So let's start our class and go to page 135. Now lesson number 6, the Rakhines. That means today we will discuss about the Rakhine ethnic groups. And where do they live? The Rakhines live in the districts of Potuakhali, Borguna and Cox's Bazar. That means the southern part of our country. And the Rakhine originally came from the Arakan region of Myanmar. That means their original abode of the Rakhine is Arakan region of the present Myanmar. And anthropologically, the Rakhines are Mongolian. That means their behavior, their nature, their customs and their society similar to the Mongolian people. And their face is round and their skin is fair and their hair is straight. So the Rakhines are Mongolian anthropologically, and the word Rakhine is derived from Rakhine. Now look, there is double K, and its meaning is conservative nation. That means they are very much protective about their culture, their religious ritual and their society or their customs. Now we will know about the social life. And the Rakhine family is mainly patriarchal. That means the father is the head of the family. And and the women are also important in their society, and they take part very effectively in the decision of the family. And economic life, the economy of the Rakhine mainly depends on agriculture, and they produce different types of crops. And they meet their demand and they also sell them in the market. And they also make cloth by tat, and this tat is hand driven. Now religious life, they follow Buddhist religions. That means they are the followers of Buddhism. And in the Rakhine village you will find a monastery, and in monastery there will be Buddha bhikkhu, and this Buddha bhikkhus teach the children about the religious norms and rules of the Buddhism. Now the cultural life, the Rakhine live in the plain land, and most of the time they live in the side of the river or coastal areas of the sea, and they build their houses on macha, on the bamboo pillars. Now look at your book, page number 136. Now look at the picture, the house of Rakhines. And now look, the house is very beautiful and it is on the macha with bamboo pillars. Now look, there is the bamboo pillars. And the Rakhines celebrate the birth anniversary of Gautam Buddha, Boishakhi Purnima, Basanto Utsav. That means the spring festival. They are very much fond of festivals, and there is another greatest festivals of Rakhines, and its name is Sangrai festival, and they celebrate it in the Chaitra Sankranti. That means the last day of the Bengali year. And the Rakhine male persons put on lungi and fatwa. They also put on pagri when they worship at the temple or when they perform any religious rituals or for and when they attend any for programs. And they put on fatwa over the lungi, and the Rakhine women put on lungi and blouse. So this is their cultural life, and this is the lifestyle about the Rakhines. Now we will go to lesson 7, and the name of this topic is the mixture and exchange of the cultures of the ethnic people of the Chakma, Marma, Santal and Rakhine with Bengalis of Bangladesh. Now my dear students, we know that there are different ethnic groups living in our country, and they have been living here for a very long time. So to meet their the demands of their life, these ethnic peoples adopt or receive different elements of our culture, and in the similar way the people of our country, that means the Bengalis, also adopt the adopt some elements from the some cultural elements from the ethnic people. So there is a cultural blending, and this cultural blending help us to create an interrelationship between the Bengalis and the ethnic people. So let's start lesson 7, and we will know what elements we get from the ethnic people, or how could it affect our culture. The exchange of the elements of one culture with another creates cultural blending, which forms a basis of intercultural relationship among the people, and it helps us to get closer to the ethnic people. Now they are the part of our country. The words used in Bengali come from the vocabulary of different ethnic groups, and we use different words from the ethnic people. We use different types of words which comes from the ethnic peoples, like thon thon, kon kon, bhon bhon, golmal, kuri, dori, kaste, nirani, hal, dheki, boitha, dula, polo, chai, etc. And New Year celebration of the minority ethnic people and Pahila Baishak of Bengali is now synonymous nowadays. So this is the festivals which is similar to the ethnic people. So we celebrate the Bengali New Year, and they also celebrate the their New Year, and we celebrate the paddy harvesting festival like Navanno, and the Garo celebrate Wangala, and this is the similar festival. That means the Garos also celebrate Wangala to celebrate the paddy harvest. Now we will know about the games and sports. Several ethnic women play in the national women football and hockey team, and this is actually the blending of exchange between the Bengalis and the ethnic people. Now economy, the crops and goods produced and made by the ethnic people fulfill the demand of the whole country and contribute to the national economy. Now look, different ethnic people produce different types of crops, especially the betel leaf of cassia is very famous, and the cassia also produce oranges, and Manipuri produces oranges which is very good, and the shawl and sari of Manipuri is very popular in our country, and nowadays the shawl and saris are also exported to the foreign countries. So they contribute to our national economy also. Now we will know about the cultural aspect. The people of minority ethnic groups are getting accustomed to the dress and food habits of the Bengalis. That means these ethnic people have traditional food habits, and they wear traditional dresses, but nowadays they also wear shirt, pants, three pieces and ornaments like ours, and they also like to eat fish, meat and soft drinks of our country. And different types of dance of the different ethnic peoples are also popular in our country and we like to watch them. Now look, Jhumur dance from Santals and the bamboo dance of Chakmas and the bottle dance of Tripuras are very popular in our country. And now their performance in the politics. The people of the minority ethnic groups participated in the liberation war and fought against the Pakistani forces, and some of them also become martyred. That means they sacrificed their life in our liberation war. And with the economic, cultural and political activities, these ethnic peoples become closer day by day. So my dear students, this is lesson 7 about the mixture and exchange of culture of the ethnic people with the Bengalis of Bangladesh. So the more we know about their culture, their society and their lifestyle, it will be easy for us to receive them, and we can make a bond between the ethnic people and the people of our country. And dear students, there is a homework for you, homework number 6, chapter 11, and you will make 6 MCQ with answer from lesson 6 and 7. So what will you do at first? You will go through lesson 6 and 7. This is the summary of lesson 6 and 7. I summarized the lesson 6 and 7. So you will go through lesson 6 and 7 carefully, then you will make 6 MCQ, that means multiple choice question answers, question with answers. And that's all for today, my dear students. I hope you have understood our today's topic. And do your homework regularly and submit it on every Sunday within 8 AM to 4 PM. So keep practicing at home and listen to your parents. See you again. Allah Hafiz.